What's up? I'm Shift, and this is what's rageworthy for the final week of the PPL regular season for the fall. We had two sets of games for EU today, starting off things with Mouse versus Virtus Pro, and would finish the day with the number one and current number two in Europe between Na'Vi and Ninjas in Pajamas. So to start things off, Mouse versus Virtus Pro. What did you miss? Not much. Mouse, actually, I lied. The first two games were actually pretty good games. They were both 4-3s. They would trade starting with Virtus Pro winning on Serpent, and then Mouse winning on Jaguar Falls. Pretty stock drafts, I would say, through and through. We're seeing a little bit more of a different variety with EU trying to pull out triple front lines, though. We'll talk more about that in our second set. But Virtus Pro tries to pull that out on Jaguar Falls using a Ruckus, Fernando, and a Barrick. And the thing about these triple frontline comps is that they're using Ying as their supporter. We'll talk more about that later. Mouse would win that game that they ran the triple front line, and then the rest of the set would pretty much go as you'd expect. Virtus Pro would win it 4-1 and 4-1. A little bit more straight up, more normal drafts there. Mouse Sports, they're looking like they're getting their things put together, but again, they keep trying to throw Alex on Kanessa on Serpent Beach, and it never really ends up working out all that well. He gets a couple of shots here and there, but the consistency of the DPS is just, I need more. It's just not at the same level as the top three in Europe are right now. And that's one thing that I think they really need to work on, is getting that consistent damage, having solid frontline gameplay as well, a couple of overextensions here and there. And meanwhile, for Virtus Pro, things are looking a little bit better now that Perdo and the rest of the gang are starting to click like they used to in the D69 days. A little bit too late for that, though, as they're going to lock in pretty much the fourth spot as they finish off their week. Coming up on Thursday. The second set had a lot of implications, NIP and Na'Vi, not necessarily for the standings, but at least for the toggle of positioning, as Na'Vi was 6-0 coming in. If they won this game here, they would for sure lock in the number one seed. NIP, the number two seed, would have to win out, including this game against Na'Vi, if they wanted to have a shot. It would be not even close to that. Na'Vi wins it three maps straight. The first game was good on Stone Keep. Went back and forth throughout all of it. It was a 4-3. And then it went to Jaguar Falls. Was a complete sweep, a 4-0. And then NIP came onto Bright Marsh as their final choice. And they would lose it 2-4. And NIP, you know, I'm going to give them, you know, a little bit of a nod of the hat. They went with the triple front line for the last two games again. And they did the same thing. It was Ruckus, Barrick, Fernando. And they would use a Ying as the support. The second game they ran Ruckus, Barrick, and Ash, not the Fernando. And both of them were kind of met with very little success. And I don't know if it's necessarily because of the triple frontliners that they picked, but I think it's more of the support that's behind it. Yes, Ying with Illusionary Rift will help those frontliners stay healthy when her ultimate is up, and that was what they were going for throughout all of it, but the sustained healing throughout when the ultimate wasn't there just doesn't really feel great. I don't know. It just feels like there are better options there. Would you have rather have seen potentially a Furia that could have produced a damage boost as the ultimate in a quick charging fashion, yet having more constant heals throughout the point where she obviously does not have her ultimate? It's kind of a toggle here and there. This is one of the reasons why triple frontline is just so hard to pull off. It has to be going up against the right comp, I think, is the biggest thing. It's not necessarily can you build the correct comp, but it's can you build a triple frontline comp while going up against the, you know, a vulnerable composition where you can pull it off. Not having a Nara in the triple front really makes it difficult because you don't have that, no pun intended, rock to sit there and soak up objective time. It's kind of like this weird triangle of trades between the other three kind of off-tank frontline roles. Fernando's Immortal was almost successful a couple of times, but again, it just looked like he had to use it in desperation mode, both when when Virtus Pro played him earlier, and then when NIP played them in their second game, it just didn't really felt like it had the same kind of effectiveness. So, I don't know. It's worth a go for sure. I would have rather have liked to see, though, on broadcast especially, NIP give Na'Vi their all. It just kind of felt like they were trying things to see if it would work, and Na'Vi just said, thanks for the free wins. I don't know. It's interesting. I don't know if we're going to see much more of that when Bomb King comes back. I don't anticipate seeing much of it, to be completely honest. I just don't think there's enough flexibility. I know, that was a really calm episode, wasn't it? Not much to rage about. This is the last week. Everything's pretty much already set in stone for the most part. So there's a couple of matchups that we're to keep our eye on for finishing out the week and the rest of the season. But until we get to qualifiers, you're pretty much going to know what you're going to get. So far, of course, with Na'Vi securing the number one, they'll be definitely going on the opposite things for NA. You're going to have Envy and G2 going to HRX. The other teams will have to go through qualifying stages. The only reason why I don't say NIP and Fnatic is because they do have a matchup that could possibly turn the tides coming up on Thursday. But that's all we got. We'll catch you guys tomorrow for NA. Until then, I don't know. Just see you then. Have a good night. Bye. Kidding. I totally lied before we go. NIP already played Fnatic, so they pretty much lock in their second seed, as Fnatic has to play up against Virtus Pro and all that goodness. So forgive me, there's not a matchup coming up on Thursday between Fnatic and NIP. It's going to be Fnatic versus VP and then Mouse versus Na'Vi to finish it off. So sorry about that. Have a good week. Bye-bye.